Hello, everybody. This is Scott Bradley coming to you from www.scottbradley.name. And in this Evernote Scott video, I'm going to show you how you can create a calendar in your Evernote software that may be able to replace your paper calendar, your iPhone calendar, or whatever other kind of calendar that you use. Now, I realize that most people like their paper calendar or they like their iPhone calendar, but I wanted to create this video to show you a creative way that you can literally take your calendar and import it into Evernote. And the best part is there's a couple ways to do that, and I'm going to show you how I would structure both of those ways and how I would use it. But first, before I jump into there, I want to let you know that I've looked at all your feedback based on one of my previous videos where I asked you if you wanted me to create an email list that will basically notify you of future videos that I make on this channel. And before I jump into the calendar, I want to show you how you can go sign up for that right now before we get started. So if you are one of those people watching my videos and you want to make sure that you always get notified of when a new one is published, here's where you have to go to sign up for that email list. We want to go to www.scottbradley.name/evernote-tips. scottbradley.name/evernote-tips. And what you're going to do is you're going to come to this form here, and it's going to say, are you ready to use Evernote more effectively? Sign up below with your name and email to be notified. Put your first name and best email in there and then click the go button. And then what's going to happen is you're going to get an email from me, and it's going to be coming from Evernote Scott, and all you got to do is click the button in that confirmation email so that I know that you really do want to get these emails. Now, I want to also let you know that I'm going to respect your privacy. I'm never going to sell your information to anybody, or send you spam of any sort. All you're going to do is get the updates of when I publish new videos with the link to the video. So whether YouTube's on or broken or not broken, you'll always get the link for all the new videos. So I wanted to let you know that I did create that for you guys, even though there were some people that wanted it, some people that didn't. I figured it was best to serve the community for those that wanted it to just create it. So I did that for you. So I hope you enjoy that. Go sign up and let's jump into the content today. So when creating your calendar, there's a couple ways to go about it. Now the first way is the more basic way, and really you can choose either one that you want depending on how your brain works and how you feel would be the best way. So I'm going to show you the easy version first and then the little more harder complex version later and how I would think about when using this. So what I've done here is create a notebook. As we know, it's, you know, click the down arrow, new notebook. And I titled this notebook Calendar 1. I just used a Calendar 1 to kind of decipher the difference between Calendar 1 option, Calendar 2 option. So if you want to go Calendar 1 option, here's how I would suggest that you set it up. All that you want to do is when you first create the notebook, pop 12 new notes in this notebook first. Put 12 new notes in the notebook first. And what this is going to do, it's going to give you every, in a sense, month for that notebook. So, you know, you can start with January, go all the way down to December, and looking at this, it looks like I totally missed one, but it's all good. That's what's great about these videos. It's totally off the cuff. And then once you create each month, then you can create each day in each month. So, you know, I just literally did, you know, going to this edit feature here, I just, you know, put 6 and then 2 spaces, and then I use this little bar line here next to the numbered list or bullet. So you just go boop, and then you go 7, 1, 2, boop, you know, 8, 1, 2, boop. So that is one way to do it, and then you can literally, you know, plan out your days. What I would probably do is make this number bold and say what day it is. I believe it's a Wednesday. And then you could literally say what's happening on January 1st. And so you can say, you know, play with the kids, meeting with John at 9 a.m. At Starbucks, etc. Now, what's also great about this is that Evernote recently launched a new feature that could help you be reminded about certain appointments in certain times. So if you look here, there's going to be a little clock here and it's like set reminder. So you can click that and it says reminder added, and you can click the little thing and it goes, when do you want to be notified about this note? Tomorrow, in a week, whatever, 7:29 at 8 a.m. So one of the ways I would use this is as, first off, let's see, first off, every time that the day finishes, the next activity that I would do for the next day, so let's say that I woke up this morning and it was Thursday, January 2nd in 2014. I would come to my Wednesday and I would literally go, sorry, shouldn't have done that. Look at the little pencil, clip here and go, okay, Wednesday's done, now we're on Thursday. Oh, and let's also delete this little bar too. So you literally can use each note as its own unique day and then basically always be coming back, redoing, looking at the day, what's up, what's coming up, so on and so on. Now, the one feature that I wanted to show you that I was just about to show you, but I wanted to show you how I would process each note first, is, again, these reminders tabs. Clear, let's just do it from scratch again. So, new reminder, add the reminder, and so let's say that you had a meeting that you wanted to be notified about. You can pop in that reminder note, you can put a reminder in this note for a future appointment. So what I would do is use this, create the reminder for the, whatever, the next day, and then as you, you know, new reminder, boom, and then let's look here. You can check it off when it's done. I mean, there's so many things that you can do with the reminders tab within this. It's a possibility for you. Now, I'm going to just share that I don't use my Evernote for a calendar, but I wanted to show you this possible option. So this is kind of option one, how I would do it. Now, option two is to create a notebook stack. Now, that's why this is calendar two, calendar 2A. And instead of saying, okay, each note in this notebook, we're just going to go bloop, hide. Instead of having each note in one notebook be a month, what you can do is basically just have it be the calendar notebook stack, and each notebook within the stack is its own month, and then each note in each month is a day. So you can literally plan out your days on a more granular level with this setup, or you can do the more general level with the calendar. So again, this is totally up to you. And again, you can also use the reminders and each day and say, oh, I have a reminder here. Thinking about this and thinking this through, the reminder would probably work better in this setup versus the calendar one setup where you make each one a month versus having each day be its own note. So that's our video for today. It's very short, sweet, and to the point. I really hope that you're enjoying these videos, and I really appreciate all of the emails that I've gotten from you asking me for the future videos and kind of sharing a little bit more about who you are, what you do, and how I can create something for you in a future video. And as I've shared with those people, I really do appreciate you reaching out to me that way, because when I exhaust all the content that I can create myself and then jump into creating the customized, if I were in this space, I'd create it this way, or if I were in this profession, I'd create it that way, that's when the videos are going to really be supercharged in the value that they're going to deliver for you guys. So I'm really excited about that. So that's pretty much it for the day. I really hope that you have a great day. Don't forget to sign up. Again, scottbradley.name/evernotetips. And again, have a great day, great rest of the week, and I will be talking to you soon. Later.